I tell the story. The first 50 pages are my journey to the house on the mesa on the top of the mountain. And I mean, I am just constantly traveling in and out of jail, getting death threats from my parishioners. As you do. I mean, the first time Jesus spoke, they wanted to throw him off the cliff. So I went, that's good. I'm doing my job. Something's going right. You see, I didn't learn that lesson. Oh, I could tell you so many funny stories. My professor of preaching at the GTU in the early 90s would just shake his head. He gave me an F. But I said, you're supposed to push their buttons. Anyway, so I move into that house, and I was so excited and happy. I never lived on my own in my whole life. If you'd saw it, you'd just, it's so magical, like way up top. Looking at it like Ghost Ranch, if you know New Mexico. And it was what Thomas Merton was looking for, and like kind of way George O'Keefe lived, is the way I live. And it's all handmade and very poor, but incredibly beautiful in the windows. And there was no furniture there. And I moved in on March 31st, 2004, and I had nothing. And so I didn't know about a house. I had all the doors and the windows open. I'm sitting on the floor in the desert with all the windows and the doors wide open as the sun is setting. And this massive white bird flew into the room. A big white dove. And it's the room is the size of this room. That's the house I live in. It's all windows with this brick floor and these massive handmade wooden beams. And this white dove is flying over my head for 20 minutes. I was partly scared and partly doing my scriptural reflections about the Genesis, the River Jordan. It was such a profound spiritual experience. What did it mean? There are no white birds in the desert of New Mexico. And you're looking at me like, what were you smoking? I don't do drugs. I'm not hallucinating. I do drink a lot of coffee. And it flew and flew and flew and flew and then disappeared. And I thought, oh, God wants me to live here. And that's partly why I wrote the book too. And I was trying to figure out, well, what is the message here? I thought, you know, in my ego was going to, I wrote this too, that I was going to be the holy guru on the mountain. Thank you very much. Well, that didn't happen. But gosh, do I feel one with creation now. I mean, the first night, I'm still trying to make you laugh, the coyotes surrounded my house after the dove. And right at 3 a.m., they all howled. And I hit the ceiling. I was so scared. Well, 15 years later now, I go out and howl with them. I know them all.